Gay says, I don't think I want that much emotion, but it's probably nice for some. So this is not wantable. Okay. And the truth is, what's telling you? So feel into what is it in your belief structure? Because it's a belief that says, I don't think I want that. Like there's something wrong with emotion. There's something dangerous about it. There's something unbearable about it. So what is it in our belief that says that? Because what is emotion? It's just another energy. It's a primal life force that wants to be expressed in itself. It wants to be seen for what it is in that sense. Everything does. Everything in reality just is what it is. And in a sense, it wants, this is kind of putting human terms on it, but it wants to be seen for what it is. So what is it in our belief that says, I don't want this, or I'm going to make distance from this? And this starts at a very young age. Very young age, when a parent scolds you for crying or scolds you for feeling something, immediately we start to distance and say, emotion's not safe. For me, I realized during retreat, I got an early sort of feeling that feeling unconditional love, feeling huge amounts of love for beings of any kind was dangerous because I would get in trouble. So if I was really in love with like living things like animals or plants or whatever, and then they died or they were taken from me, or someone said, why are you so, God, give me that. You would get this wound and it felt like, okay, that's not safe to do. So then you develop a belief, not safe to feel that. And then only years later do you realize that was just a belief. That was just conditioning. It was totally innocent on all parts, the people who did the conditioning and the one that was conditioned. It was innocent. So can you feel it now? Is it okay to feel this incredible amount of love for people and things that maybe aren't deserving of it based on belief? So let the belief go. What does deserving mean anymore? Now it's just radical acceptance of what is, of who is, of how they are.